Today, I'd like to talk to you about setting up your table square within 1 thou, and if it's possible. I will cut to the chase. No, it's not possible. But if it is possible, I'll show you how to do it. Why isn't it possible? Well, let's just take your table to start. As you can see, this one's got the tape on it. It was ripped when it was arrived. Overlaps, seams, creases, snowflakes, chance in hell. But I don't use tape. If you look at my sticky matters video, the 3Dprint4A sticky matters video, you'll see what I use. So I have a bare, clean table. So even if you strip it off bare and clean, to set it up within 1 thou, that means that this has to be within 1 thou. No distortion, no dishing, no bowing. And just say it came off the manufacturing plant like that. When they roll material, it's under pressure, so it has stresses in it already. As soon as they cut this, it would have distorted. Each time you heat it up, it does a bit of stress relief. It distorts a bit. You have the pressure on your springs. Now, you may say, oh, that's not much of a force. Look what gravity does over time. So it heats up, cools down. So even if this was perfect, to get it flat, you can get yourself float glass, bit of lapping compound, and lap it. Ignoring that, even if you've got that flat, it's also the mounting. I'm not talking about the table itself. I'm talking about the arms here. See how the rod moves. See how that moves. I've put the dial indicator on with my special mount. I don't know if you can pick that up, but I'll lower it down. Part of the process too, if you looked at the video on my special Z-axis switch, got the bracket, got the lever, easy to set up. And when you are setting it up, this needs to be done before you put your hot end assembly up, before you put your belts on X and Y, because you want to move the table freely. If you have the steppers connected, if you look in there, there's a little LED. Now, I don't know if you can pick it up. When you pull along, it starts to glow. Means there's back EMF in there, electricity. So you don't want that. I've got this universal mount here. To do it properly, and this is just to show you the principle today, is that without your assembly, you would just make up a... You can use wood, square bit of wood, that size hole in it, a slit like a keyhole, drill a hole through, so as you could just clamp it tight, and then just put another drill hole for where that mounting screw is underneath. So then you can just put a bolt through there, clamp the block of wood, and then clamp that in. And then the spindle will be on the position of that. You'll see why that's important later. So you put it on, but before you even do that, this table and this rail can be parallel, but they'll also be parallel like that. They'll also be parallel like that. They'll also be parallel like that. These arms can be over like that, or like that, or like that, or like that. Now the important thing is to get this angle and that angle 90 degrees. That's where you set the height of those. So what you do is when you're setting up your lead screws there, you set the grub screw pointing out, you set the grub screw pointing out. The second grub screw pointing to the right, second grub screw pointing to the right. Then they are aligned. You can nip this one up to the flexible coupling, but don't have this one nipped up. So then you adjust it. I use a vernier to measure from there to there, and then I just turn the screw that lifts that end up and down, and when they're both spot on with the vernier, digital caliper. Old school. You then nip it up and then you know that that's the height, because you're doing this manually and sometimes you go the wrong way and you turn the wrong one. So I can do it by finger, and if I are out, I then know that I just have to set that one perpendicular, and the height's the same. Now let's see if we can read this. For example, that's 2 millimeter. This is a digital indicator, plunger type, stand type. But look what happens when I just move this. See how the whole head moves. This is all the slack you've got. Now I'll just move the table again. There's over a millimeter movement there. And that's that part of the table. So there's a millimeter. So as you can see, it's a bit difficult to get it within 1 thou. However, to easily get it the best you can, that's what I'm going to show you today. So without the hot end, with this just mounted in, that's free to go. You set it up square, then what you do, put your dial indicator, switch it on, zero it. Now this doesn't zero that well, because each time you press the zero button, it moves. You pick one corner. Let's say this is zero. And then you push it across this way. That's 1 millimeter. So then, you know that's a 3.5 mil, so you have to move that down 2 turns. So you then get that down to zero. So then you keep adjusting it and checking. These tend to move, they're on the spring. When you put your springs in, make sure they're all straight, they're not cocked over, they're all equal. What I did is I squeezed these down to tight, zero gap, then backed them off 2 millimeter. You set that to be zero. Zero. And this is why you'll notice now this needs to be in the center, because you don't have as much trouble So then you move up to the next one. And that was zero, that's 0.13, let's get it in thou, that's seventh thou up to there. So you can nip that up. Then you go over to the other corner and you can nip that up. When you get that corner on zero, 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 move it backwards and forwards so as your spring settle. Then measure, then just go over to the center. That's two thou. So that will tell you whether your table is curved in or dished up. If it's curved in, when you set your nozzle height, you know that if you had it too close there, it may hit here, your 0.2 of a millimeter. Depends on your dish and all that. Or if it bows up, you can have it tighter on the top because you know there'll be clearance on there. So that's all you have to do. Make up a mount, set it up, and just move the table around and adjust it. No bits of paper, nothing like that. Then you might say, oh, okay, that's fine for the table. Now, what about the height? If you look at my excellent Cossel video, the series, you'll see that I use a piece of round tool steel that's very good. And the Cossel is a lot better set up in so much as it has a limit switch up here. So when it hits up here, you then just have to add in a dimension for your table height. So much easier. But all you do there is you just lower your head down until the nozzle just, so when that slides in at the thickness of whatever tool steel you're using, you zero the dial. You then get it to trigger the switch over here. You can see in here the little nylon standoffs coming to go down, and you listen. There it is, click. So you've zeroed your dial at 3.6 millimeter, too high. So with the screw adjuster, again, that's M3, half a mil per turn, six turns, has to go up six. Then I know it is spot on. If I wanted to be 0.2 of a millimeter, I know that I can lower this down and say, right, bang, there it is. Just that to get rid of the offset, then less your 0.2. So then I can check it. You can listen. Click, then slide your paper in. Quite simple, quite easy. These are very cheap now. They used to be hundreds of dollars, hundreds of dollars. Now you can get one. Well, this one was $32. They're even cheaper now. So that's all you have to do. Just easily check your table and easily set your home bed height. So if you enjoyed this video, tell your friends and subscribe, spread the word. If you haven't, tell me. And as always, thanks for watching.